as Taliban, backed by Pakistan, advances and one city after the other falls, there is an increasing threat to the lives of minority Hindu and Sikh families in Afghanistan. Young Congress leader Jaiveer Shergill has written a letter to the External Affairs Minister seeking urgent intervention and evacuation of Hindus and Sikhs from Afghanistan. The BJP has hit back, accusing the Congress of double standards, saying the same Congress party had opposed the Citizenship Amendment Act meant to help the same minority Hindus and Sikhs in India's neighborhood. Anand Patel gets you this top story. With every new conquest of the Taliban in Afghanistan, the threat to the minority Sikh and Hindu communities is rapidly rising. A knock on the door from Islamist extremists is a fear that Hindus and Sikhs are constantly living with. Sikhs and Hindus have appealed to the international community for urgent evacuation, and they've now got support from a Congress leader in India. Jaiveer Shergill has written a letter to the External Affairs Minister, S. Jaishankar, seeking help, saying India must consider giving special visas to minority Sikhs and Hindus trapped in Afghanistan. He raised the issue of the attack in Jalalabad, in which 19 Sikhs and Hindus were killed, to show the urgency. Jaiveer Shergill also said around 650 Sikhs and 50 Hindus are targets of the Taliban in Afghanistan. Persecuted Hindus and Sikhs are amongst the six religious minorities that stand to benefit from CAA in our neighborhood. The government had last year given visas to 11 Sikh and Hindus from Afghanistan as a special case. Among them, Nidan Singh Sachdeva, who was abducted from a Gurdwara and later released by the Taliban.
Sikha dona to bahut tang han, jawan kudi bahar nahi nikal sakdi. 15-20 din pehle sade ek kudi nu leke gaye si te ohna nu eh shukr ke vaigu sarkar di benti oh aegi ke ohna ne wapas leke aaye.
The letter by the Congress leader comes in the backdrop of a recent appeal issued by the Sikh and the Hindu communities of war-torn Afghanistan to rescue them to safety. The government of India will need to act swiftly before it's too late. With camera person Sanjeev, this is Anand Patel in New Delhi for India Today.
And Congress leader Jaiveer Shergill joins me on India First. Jaiveer Shergill, Hindu and Sikh minorities have been targeted by radical Islamist forces in Afghanistan even earlier. What prompted you to write this letter to the External Affairs Minister this time?
Thank you, Gaurav ji, firstly, for having me on the show. And let me make it very clear up front. I have written this letter in my personal capacity as a concerned Indian citizen belonging to the Sikh community. I'm very sure my colleague from the Congress party agree with me. A similar request was made by Captain Amrinder Singh, our democratically elected chief minister, last year when 25 Sikhs were killed in a attack on Gurdwara Sahib last year, as you're well aware. Now, why did I write this letter? There's a famous Afghan proverb which was used in Soviet time. They may have the watches, but we have the time. But unfortunately, time is running for minorities of Indian origin. By definition, includes Hindus and Sikhs only in Afghanistan. Today, Taliban has sucked Afghanistan in a vortex of violence and death. The minority of Indian origin, Hindu and Sikhs, are a sitting duck target for the Taliban execution squad. You cover extensively security issues, you know, Taliban has consistently, persistently, and in a sinister strategy form, has targeted and wants to eliminate the face of minority of Indian origin from Afghanistan. To give you brief stats, 700,000, 7 lakh people of Indian origin used to live in Afghanistan in 70s. Yes. Today, they are less than 700. So in minority of Indian origin are evaporating from Afghanistan like water drops evaporate on a bright sunny day. Why I wrote this letter, the government of the day, there is no politics on it. Last year, 2018 Jalalabad attack, last year 19 Sikh killed, then 25, now Nishan Sahib asked to be removed. Last year, BJP government brought 300 people from Afghanistan during COVID. then Sikhs and Hindus were brought. So today, this is a humanitarian call to get these people as fast before they are executed at the gunpoint by Taliban, backed by Pakistan.
But J.V. Shergill, the BJP accuses the Congress of blatant double standards. The Citizenship Amendment Act was brought in to help the same minority Hindus and Sikhs that you choose to protect or you talk about protecting today in countries like Afghanistan and Pakistan. Congress opposed CAA tooth and nail. Now you seek urgent intervention for the same Sikhs and Hindus that the CAA tried to protect.
Gauravji, there is a very famous Hindi saying, pehle tolo, phir bolo. भाजपा के साथ समस्या है, बिना तोले बोल देती है. बीजेपी इज अ ब्रिगेड ऑफ जंपिंग जैक्स हु नाइदर रीड द कंटेंट नॉर अंडरस्टैंड द सब्सटेंस बट मेयरली थ्रो एलिगेशंस. लेट मी मेक इट वेरी क्लियर विदाउट मिंसिंग एनी वर्ड्स. टुडे इफ देयर वाज एनी मुस्लिम माइनॉरिटी ऑफ इंडियन ओरिजिन इन अफगानिस्तान आई वुड हैव इंक्लूडेड देम इन द लेटर. As per Afghan constitution, and as you said, there are six religious minorities and only one religious minority belongs to India, Indian origin, in which there are only Hindus and Sikhs. So if there were Muslims of Indian origin belonging to that classification of religious minority, as per Afghan constitution, I would have taken their name. Second, BJP is a brigade of hypocrites. BJP till date has not even framed the CAA rules, which they were drum beating throughout the nation. Number three, I will clarify on your state esteemed channel that I, Jaiveer Shergill, along with the Congress party, stand firm by my stand that the current version of NRC and CAA is a cocktail of disaster, a tool to deport Indian citizens, transform 19.5 lakh Indian citizens in Assam, which included 15 lakh Hindus who were labeled aliens in their own country, out of the country, and bring people in on discriminatory basis.
So that now you've added an NRC. If I may come back to the point of Hindus and Sikhs being persecuted by radical Islamists in Afghanistan, the Taliban that's backed by Pakistan army, and the persecution of Hindus and Sikhs in Pakistan. Is your stand in various with the Congress party on the Citizenship Amendment Act, simply on CAA? I'm not bringing in the NRC at this point of time. After all, you seek the evacuation of minority Hindus and Sikhs, the protection that CAA chooses to provide.
Let's, rather than looking for a needle in a haystack, let's separate the wheat from the chaff. Two points, and I'll make them very crisp. Firstly, India has a long, rich, before the BJP came into the power, rich diplomatic, cultural, and a moral tradition to evacuate people of Indian origin, starting from Kuwait crisis of 1991 to last year, BJP government itself bringing Hindu and Sikhs. Did they bring Hindu and Sikhs under CEA last year? No, they gave them a special visa. Some of them have already gone back to Afghanistan on pure consideration that Afghanistan is a war-torn nation. We need to protect Indian origin. Number two, in the BJP version of CEA, which I oppose, if you are a Muslim and of Indian origin, you cannot apply for citizenship on a bare text and the rules have not come. In my thing, if there was a Muslim of Indian origin.
Okay, give me a moment. I'll BJP, try and restart. Yes, we've got it back. Go on, sir.
BJP, rather than indulging in cheap politics, should focus on evacuating from a war-torn nation rather than playing these political games with the Congress party. But I don't blame them. BJP is even looking for credit for Olympic medals, that even a BJP guy threw a javelin instead of Neeraj Chopra. That is their laughable kind of a greed for seeking publicity.
Politics aside, today, but when you say bring them to India, the 700 right. Hindus and Sikhs, when you say bring them to India from Afghanistan, because if they stay there, they will be executed by the Taliban backed by Pakistan. Bring them to India and then do what? Settle them here? Give them citizenship or keep them stateless to perhaps one day hope that Afghanistan will be free of Taliban and send them back?
No, see, it is not my place. My simple request to the Honorable Minister Jai Shankar Ji, without getting into politicization of the matter, is please follow your March 2020 and August 2020 model of repatriation and giving them the status. Subject to factual correction, last year they were brought by special status visa, a long-term visa. but some of them complained they did not get the economic security by simple demand with folded hands. Till the situation improves in Taliban, on consent basis, they should be brought back into India on a special visa like the BJP government did last year. They should be given economic security. And then the issue of citizenship, okay. No citizenship, refugee, no refugee, permanent status, no permanent status. These are all matters of form. Today, fair lives enough. Are in danger, as you rightly know. Taliban is crumbling and crushing Afghanistan like a pack of cards. Today, Indian minorities, like many other communities of all stripes, are living in fear and paranoia. This issue is much larger than Congress and Bharatiya Janata Party. BJP should be focusing on sending a plane to Afghanistan. If today our government, who says we will bring XYZ religious minority from across the nation, cannot stand with people of Afghanistan of Indian origin, what will they do in future? It okay. is laughable.
So first, you're saying bring back Hindus and Sikhs of Afghanistan to save their lives or they will be executed by the Taliban.
Gaurav, just give me 30 seconds.
Go on,
just give me 30 seconds. And you are well aware, Gauravji, all nations, America doesn't have a CAA law. Britain doesn't have a CAA law. People who have boots on the ground, whose citizens or their origins have boots on the ground, they are being evacuated. Americans are even evacuating the Afghans who helped them translating the language. The British are maybe doing the same thing. Today, who should they go to if not India? Who should a okay. Hindu and a Sikh go to if not India? Should they seek Joe Biden's help? Clearly, no.
That's the point. No, it was that's Congress the point that the Union Home Minister Amit Shah had also made. Who will Hindus and Sikhs or minorities go to except India? That's the point that Prime Minister has also been making. But for the moment, Jaiveer Shergill, many thanks for joining me. I want to widen the scope of this debate, bring in R.P. Singh of the Bharatiya Janata Party and Saira Shah Haleem, an analyst strongly opposed to the Citizenship Amendment Act. R.P. Singh, Congress says this is Jaiveer Shergill's individual stance, not that of the party. But Jaiveer Shergill asks, how is this double standards or double speak?
Thank you, Gaurav, for getting me in the debate. I would have appreciated that Jaiveer stayed on the debate. First, had he stayed on the debate, I would have said that welcome on board. I mean, you're welcome on board. At least you started speaking for Hindus and Sikhs who are stuck in Afghanistan because this election coming in Punjab and you need to send a message because it is otherwise. Let me read out what Jaiveer has said. The CA 2019 by intent of structure is a communal atom bomb dropped to destroy the sacral fabric of a nation. I don't know how CA was against the sacral fabric of this nation because CA was not distinguishing between the Indians. It was only for people who are like now they're in stuck in Afghanistan. Who knows? Yes, ultimately they will be killed by.
So it was for those people. And I'm shocked. I mean, Gyan will talk about that anyone who is stuck. But at that time, they're saying, why can't Muslims who can't come to this country? And now you're saying that if American is stuck somewhere, sir, if American is stuck, if Indian is stuck, these people are people of Indian origin, not Indian. Yes. They're people who are raised in Afghanistan, who have grown up in Afghanistan, who are Afghanistan children, but their origins are Indian. That's why we're asking them, we're giving them protection. And let me reassure you that every Indian person of Indian origin in Afghanistan will be given safety, and then we will ensure that each one of them is taken care.
Well,
that Mr. Shergill will be very clear on this. But let's
know. Okay, God willing, because the situation is extremely brink. Give me a moment. Let me also bring Saira Shah Haleem. Let me bring in Saira Shah Haleem. Saira Shah Haleem, this is exactly what the Citizenship Amendment Act attempted to do, what Jaiveer Shergill writes today. Protect Hindus, protect Sikhs in Afghanistan. The same situation in Pakistan, similar in Bangladesh. And yet, such a strong opposition to CAA. Was that entire opposition ill-founded and purely politics, ma'am?
Okay, let me be very clear, Mr. Sawant, that it is not about Hindus or Sikhs. I think so far, the Taliban and the radical outfits in Afghanistan have targeted Indian interests. And I'm iterating the word Indian here. Let's not forget the...
Ma'am, you read Jaiveer Shergill's letter. Jaiveer Shergill's letter very categorically mentions 700 Hindus and Sikhs remain in Afghanistan. They will be executed. They need to be protected. It's not about Indian interests, it's Hindus specifically. But let me, Saira, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
So it's very specific about Hindus and Sikhs, ma'am. Okay, if you've read that letter.
Let me just add to what Mr. Shergill was saying. I definitely agree with him that minorities are endangered in Afghanistan. And the Taliban has taken over more provincial territories in the last 2 months, which is a worrying sign indeed. And minorities definitely have to be evacuated.
Minorities are Hindus and Sikhs.
I said minorities in Afghanistan.
Are Hindus and Sikhs.
Minorities in Afghanistan are Hindus and Sikhs.
Yes.
Definitely.
Then why this opposition to CAA, ma'am?
No, because India has never, ever been differential as far as religion is concerned when it categorizes who a persecuted community is. Let us say which religion did Danish Siddiqui belong to. He was an Indian first. And I'm emphasizing, when you are in a country that is swarmed by radicals, they do not look at Hindu, Muslim, Sikh, Christian. And I feel all Indians who are working there in embassies, in medical relief camp, at consulates, at reconstruction sites, have to be evacuated.
No, Indian citizens will automatically be evacuated. Okay. And Danish Siddiqui was an Indian citizen. So Danish Siddiqui, these are people of Indian origin who are Afghan citizens.
But Indian Muslim who is working in Afghanistan. Right now, there are more than 3,000 Indian officials who are working
in Afghanistan. No, ma'am, I don't think you're appreciating the problem, ma'am. Okay, RP Singh wants to respond. RP Singh wants to respond to you. Go on, sir.
Work spheres in Afghanistan, they all need to be evacuated.
Thank you. They all will be evacuated, but they are not, these people are not Indian citizens. They are people of Indian origin. There's a difference between people of Indian origin and citizens. And then when we talk about people of Indian origin, Muslims in Afghanistan are not people of Indian origin. They are Muslims there. And then there are many more nations to go. Or Rohingyas, Rohingyas are not people of Indian origin. There's a difference. That's why They can't be given citizenship here, or they can't be allowed to be given a refuge here. There's a difference. So let's be clear. This is a hypocrisy in Congress. I'm saying it in the record. Gavin Shergill is targeting forthcoming election in Punjab. That's why he's speaking on this tone and turn. Otherwise, he should call his friend Najjar Singh Sidhu, who said, "Mera yaar dildar Imran Khan," and it's Imran Khan who's supporting Taliban today. Everyone knows it's Imran Khan who's supporting Taliban. It's the Pakistan army who's supporting Pakistan Taliban.
Okay.
And he used to go and do jaffis with the Bajwa.
So Saira Shah Ali, is the opposition to CAA based on lack of knowledge, lack of information, and lack of what CAA was all about? Now, if there is an Indian Muslim, of course it's the government's responsibility to evacuate an Indian Muslim who's stuck anywhere in the world. But it's not the government's. Ma'am, please hear me out. Please hear me out. It's the government's responsibility to evacuate every Indian Muslim. Yes. But this CAA is about people of Indian origin. These Hindus and Sikhs are not Indian citizens, ma'am. That is what CAA was all about.
Aren't the Ahmadiyyas persecuted community in Pakistan? Aren't the Shias persecuted community in Pakistan? Why discriminate them? Aren't they a religious minority in Pakistan?
What are we talking about?
Sir, please let her complete her point, sir. Sir, please let her finish her point. I'll come to you to respond to that. Sir, hold on. Please let Saira Shah Halim complete her point, sir. Go on, ma'am.
I am iterating once again here. Aren't the Shias a religious minority in Pakistan? Aren't they getting murdered? Aren't they being attacked? What about the Ahmadiyya community? Aren't they a persecuted community?
Okay.
Won't they get protection under CAA?
Ma'am, you consider Ahmadiyyas Muslims?
What are we talking here? I think every persecuted community, whether in Afghanistan, whether in Pakistan, or any other neighboring company, should be given asylum.
Okay. RP Singh, please respond, sir.
India.
RP Singh, please respond. Please respond. Why not Shias and Ahmadiyyas in Pakistan?
I'll answer that. Okay. Sikhs are Hindu. Can they take refuge in UAE, Dubai, Oman, Mauritius, or any of the Muslim countries? No, they can't. But yes, Ahmadiyyas can, Shias can. There are countries that Iran will give them refuge.
So they have their nation where they can go. But where will Sikhs and Hindus go? They have only one country to go, which is India. So that's why we are allowing them to come to India under CA and take the citizenship route here. So don't mix up. And then don't mix up between origin and citizenship. Any citizen of India worldwide stuck anywhere, it's the responsibility of government of India. But yes, people of Indian origin, which include Sikhs and Hindus, will be taken care of by government of India.
Okay. Saira Shah Haleem, respond to this fact. This law is only for religions that originated in India. Now, the religion that is followed by Ahmadiyyas or Shias did not originate in India. That is what the Citizenship Amendment Act is all about, according to Sardar R.P. Singh.
I would like to tell Mr. R.P. Singh that the act is completely illogical, not because it leaves out of the purview the largest group of stateless refugees currently living in Indian soil, that is Tamils from Sri Lanka. How have you forgotten them? And many of them are in fact Hindus. I'm not even talking about Shias or Ahmadiyyas. And suddenly it singles out only one particular community, that is Islam, for particularly spiteful, ill-intentioned interests.
Ma'am, but which Muslim is being persecuted by the Taliban by the way Hindus and Sikhs are? If you go by Javier Shergill's letter, which Muslim is being persecuted by the Taliban? And this is for Hindus and Sikhs.
Mr. Danish Siddiqui.
Danish Siddiqui was an Indian citizen, ma'am. It is Government of India's responsibility. But this is about people of Indian origin, ma'am. I think that there is a basic difference.
The Taliban has consistently attacked Indian interests. And since the time it was ousted in 2001, if you look at the entire track record till to 2021, including the recent attack on our very, very illustrious journalist, Mr. Danish Siddiqui, how can we forget that? So let us not get religion in here. I think every persecuted community should be welcomed warmly in India. And I feel it is not about, it shouldn't be about religion. We should not look at who a persecuted community with.
R.P. Singh, respond. R.P. Singh, Saira Shah Haleem says Tamils. Then. But again, ma'am, I think that very basic issue, and I sincerely want every Indian to read the Citizenship Amendment Act and not go by just the commentary, a lot of commentary and ill-informed commentary that's doing the rounds in public domain, which led to a lot of people saying, "Hum kagaz nahi dikhayenge aur ye nahi karenge aur wo nahi karenge." Ma'am, vaccine lagane ke liye to sabne kagaz dikhaya. But besides the point. But seriously. But let's come back to the core issue. Let's come back to the core issue. R.P. Singh, respond to the point that irrespective of religion, anyone persecuted anywhere, Indians should give them, refuge in our country.
No, she is mixing up two issues. One is citizenship and one is people of Indian origin. If she, as Sarah Ali Haleem, is stuck in any country, yes, it's the son of India, Indian government to get her work credit. But if Sarah Ali, some other from Afghanistan is stuck somewhere, it's not our responsibility. Then let the Afghan government take care of her. But she's not Indian. So there's a difference between people of Indian origin and citizenship. If Danish Siddiqui was Indian, so it's responsibility for Indian government to do whatever they can do for Danish Siddiqui. They should have done it. But that's why
the
give me a second. Hear me out. But if people of Indian origin are stuck, they have no other nation to go. Muslims have 50 nations to go worldwide. Shias and Sunnis have nations where they can go and take refuge. But Hindus and Sikhs have no other nation to go other than India. And then especially, which Muslim is being prosecuted in Afghanistan? Tell us that. Which Muslim is being prosecuted in Pakistan? Tell us that. I mean, you are saying Ahmadiyyas and Shias have been prosecuted, but they are people who are going there with their own intention. And then they are not people of Indian origin anymore. They are people, Sikhs and Hindus are religion of Indian origin.
Saira Shah Haleem, those opposing Citizenship Amendment Act, what do they want with these persecuted Hindus and Sikhs in Afghanistan? What should happen to them? Should the Taliban kill them there? Should they be raped and forcibly converted, as is happening both in Pakistan and in Afghanistan? Or is India their country and that they should be brought to India and should they need it, then they should, their citizenship should be speeded up, ma'am.
Two sentences, please. Okay. Firstly, any persecuted community right now, it's the Hindus as well as the Sikhs in Afghanistan. Definitely, they have to be given high priority and evacuated as soon as possible. Now, as far as this gentleman was talking about the NRCCA, a very, very small example in layman's language. Now, supposing an NRC, somebody says...
Ma'am, suppose an NRC is a separate issue. Ma'am, NRC is a separate issue. Today I'm specifically on Citizenship Amendment Act. Ma'am, when everybody, when all those who came out on the streets, ma'am, on India Today, we discuss facts. Facts and pure facts. Jab NRC hoga, to aisa hoga. That is. Let's discuss facts.
Mr. Samant,
when NRC comes, then we will see. Is a separate story. But today we'll stay on facts. And the Citizenship Amendment Act is different.
So the biggest fact here is a non-Muslim has the opportunity to tell the government, sir, I don't have documents under the NRC.
NRC is a separate issue. Today it's about Citizenship Amendment Act. And that is why we need to stay on facts. Anyways, I've run out of time on this part of the debate. It is a heated issue, but that is why issues must be discussed purely on facts and not fear-mongering.